A correction on that young Republican father who, quote-unquote, died of COVID, and some that mainstream media is hiding the fact that BLM increases murders, but they're insisting that COVID has increased overall deaths. It's all very confusing. This is the end of hour one of the Jesse Lee Peterson Show, Thursday, December 31st, 2020. Happy New Year's Eve, everybody. Stay tuned for hour two. Jesse Lee Peterson will be right back. But first, Hake news, not fake news. I got this from the internet. This 41-year-old congressman-elect, whom I told you about yesterday on Hake News and the Hake Report, died of a heart attack, really. Not strictly COVID-19, as was reported. Fox News reports that Luke Letlow, the newly elected member of Congress from Louisiana, died Tuesday night from complications related to COVID-19, they say. He'd been hospitalized after being diagnosed with the virus. He was days away from being sworn into office. I think this Sunday he was supposed to be sworn in. Dr. G.E. Ghali, G-H-A-L-I, of LSU Health Shreveport, told NOLA.com, N-O-L-A, New Orleans Advocate, I think, that Letlow was in critical condition but showed signs of improvement. He apparently suffered a cardiac event this evening that was refractory to all resuscitation efforts. This same Dr. Ghali guy claimed that it was all COVID-related, which in my opinion is a lie or either misunderstood. Either that or misunderstood. He was obese, this young man. Not that fat, but he was fat. And he had just run a campaign. Perhaps he had overworked himself. And this is not very uncommon to die from this. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention states, among adults hospitalized with flu during recent flu seasons, heart disease was one of the most commonly occurring chronic conditions. About half of adults hospitalized with flu that season had heart disease. Studies have shown that flu illness is associated with an increase of heart attacks and stroke, by the way. A 2018 study found that the risk of heart attack was 6 times higher within a week of a confirmed flu infection. These findings were most pronounced for older adults and those experiencing their first heart attack. Additionally, a 2020 study that looked at more than 80,000 U.S. adults hospitalized with the flu of over 8 flu seasons found that sudden serious heart complications were common and occurred in one of out of every 8 patients. That's about 12% of patients. By the way, it was reported late November that Johns Hopkins pulled an article that it admitted that coronavirus had not raised the total death toll. A quote from Yanni Gu on November 22nd at Johns Hopkins University said, surprisingly, the deaths of older people stayed the same before and after COVID-19. Since COVID-19 mainly affects the elderly, experts expected an increase in the percentage of deaths in older age groups. However, this increase was not seen in the CDC data. In fact, percentages of deaths among all age groups remain relatively the same. Johns Hopkins erased the content of that article titled A Closer Look at U.S. Deaths Due to COVID-19. They claim that as of November 27th, according to the CDC, there had been almost 300,000 excess deaths due to COVID-19. I don't know. And the mainstream media is hiding the fact that BLM, Black Lives Matter, also known as Burn, Loot, Murder, increases murders. The Associated Press, far left enemies of America, AP, is using a clever media trick, according to Revolver News, to downplay recent crime surge data. The Associated Press tweeted December 30th, yesterday, that violence has surged in the U.S. during the pandemic. So did Black Lives Matter, right? But insists experts say there is no clear-cut reason. Remember, this has been the year of nationwide and worldwide Black Lives Matter riots. 93% peaceful, though, right? The dishonest media and liberal criminologists, quote-unquote, did the same to obscure the clear reality of the Ferguson effect, increase of murders with the increase of Black Lives Matter justification that Heather McDonald described years ago in her book, The War on Cops. In the first wave of the Black Lives Matter riots. I'm James Hake, now on to Jesse, Hour 2.